All right, Kevin. Let's see what you're made of.
Scattered bones, stripped clean of flesh, lay in stark contrast to the dead left untouched. Hunger and malice thrived. The lost trenches, the new residents of the goblin hordes.
Kevin is quick and stealthy. With each hit, he stacks frenzy. The more frenzy he has, the quicker his attacks become. The color of the frenzy bar changes to represent the amount of frenzy. Frenzy depletes over time. Okay. So quick. What is that? Increase movement speed and dodge chance at the cost of losing the ability to evade. Eh, fuck it, dude. Who cares? Talk about that damage. Oh, it's an R. You have to use it. Gotcha.
Steps were taken without regret, for it was never possible to change a destiny unknown.
Alright, sounds good, Corn. I don't understand how you're supposed to do that one. What the fuck do you do here? What are those? Oh, stun buddy. I think that will be useful.
K, kept in check by a ne'er-dyer's will, the goblin hordes never dared to linger in her caves. Their place was in the bloodless forest, banished for their brutality. As the conversation turned to the progress of the corruption, Mary was curious to know which village had been attacked this time. However, that worry gave way to panic when Lucy entered. Poor beasts, all slaughtered. Maybe something had infected them. The corruption was on their doorstep now. The goblin bandits had been preying on Aneadias pilgrims with unprecedented cruelty. Removing the evil would help those who had taken refuge in the cave. Ben had heard that the goblin sibling's lair was somewhere in the lost trenches. The Bergsons had to deal with those two as soon as they could.
All right, Kevin.
Can the body endure the mind's gamble?
Motherfucker. A lot of freaking chests I can't open. Reset cooldowns of all your abilities and fill your rage. That is a short floor. Just let that happen, dude.
While painful, for a mother to see her son in sickness was still better than missing him for so long. Mary knew that she would make caring for Mark her mission. Mark had to warn them about the dangers approaching, despite how difficult it was to talk. He started naming the villages that were evacuated, or worse, taken over by the corruption, but soon succumbed to fatigue. And fell asleep. Mary recalled hearing of an herbalist in Caldipo Caves that would have the yarrow at hand needed to treat Mark. The Bergsons would once again need to brave the treacherous caves in search of the herbalist. Margaret knew full well that signs and symbols were seldom obvious and never direct. She was certain that the cause of the corruption would be difficult to discover. Finding the herbalist was the most pressing matter. The healing herb needed to be taken to Mary as soon as possible.
Ah!
Guess I'll just die on the first floor then. Creates a totem that shoots bitches. Seems good. Wow, he just fucking one-shot me. course, I had not that much health, but...
The heat had only grown more intense in the young child's hands, far stronger than any would suspect in one so young. Her training could no longer be just a pastime, for fire was a dangerous friend.
Ooh.